Hello guys, how's it going? Wow, it's been a while since I posted a video online because I was out sailing and as usual there was no internet on ship. Now I'm back and today's video is about a heat exchanger slash cooler on ship, and we're gonna go through the inspection, the cleanup and what to check during the inspection. So let's go. So we have two sets of vacuum pump coolers on board. These are the two pump motors coupled with the pump, and next to them are the two coolers. Based on the design, just one cooler is sufficient to keep the system running. The second cooler is more a standby in case the first one breaks down or has to be opened up for cleaning or any other maintenance. The vacuum pump has a freshwater seal inside, also known as the liquid ring priming arrangement. That, together with the eccentric shaft along with an odd number of working pistons, enable the vacuum pump to work as it should. This water header tank is where the vacuum pump gets its fresh water. The tank in turn has a hydrophore connection for topping up. There's also a sight glass to check the actual water level in the header tank. Coming to the coolers, these are the shell and tube type with a double pass. Even though the vacuum system is not in use right now, and both the coolers can actually be opened up simultaneously, I still prefer to carry out this job one cooler at a time. To isolate these coolers, I have shut the inlet and outlet butterfly valves and drained the content via the drain valve fitted. Once drained, the end covers have been removed. Before starting work on any system, we should ensure that it is isolated, depressurized, and drained off contents. Working fluid in the vacuum pump cooler is seawater. And no matter what kind of filters and anti-fouling systems you have on your ship, some contamination will definitely find its way to them coolers. This actually doesn't look so bad because as you can see, most of the tubes are still clear. Now, as I already mentioned that the working fluid is seawater, so to protect the material from corrosion, we have some sacrificial anodes fitted to the body. Besides the general cleaning that is carried out, it is absolutely important to check for the condition of these anodes. And by experience, you would know when to replace them. Failure to do this in a timely and routine manner would result in corrosion of these tubes and even the shell. And then it's a much bigger job to fix that. As you can see, the anodes are of different sizes. It's because of the location where they're installed. The two smaller ones are from these two pockets. And this is what it looks like when installed and in use. The bigger one is from here, and right next to it is how it looks like when in operation. It is important to remember that all the gaskets and jointing should be renewed so as to avoid what's called a double job later on. I mean, doing the same thing all over again because now a gasket which was not replaced is leaking. In some cases like this one, the seawater pipe have an internal rubber coating to prevent them from corrosion. Check their condition, just in case they're peeling off. And you can apply some glue, I mean the kind which is available and used in fresh water generator, to stick the rubber back. Do not try to remove or pull this internal layer because then you can't put it back and most likely you'll have to renew the entire pipe. Also, do not use any kind of glue because a wrong type of glue would make the rubber hard and brittle and it would break with time. Now, how to clean these tubes? Well, the instruction manual will tell you about some special long brushes with copper bristle, etc. at the head, but trust me, they are more time consuming and there are easier ways. What is being done here is that we cut a section of a spare copper tube of suitable diameter, that is based on the cooler tube diameter, and make it into a long nozzle. You can either use compressed air or water from the hydrophore system to blow into these tubes, and that's how they get clean. I prefer not to make the area too messy for the cleanup part which will come later, so if possible, I mean of course, cooler size permitting, try to put a garbage bag or a big cover on the other side while you're blowing air from the front end. And cause you are using air and not water, so the amount of waste that you're gonna generate will be even lesser. I mean, there is not much dirty water coming in the garbage bag. This is a routine job, but at times if a tube is found to be clogged, then one can also use a copper, iron, or even a steel rod of suitable diameter and knock off the clog. Although I would say that the technique is more suitable for large size coolers or heat exchangers, which would have a significantly larger tube diameter. Once the airflow is complete, then have a quick final look at the condition. If satisfied, the cooler components can be boxed back in the reverse order as they were assembled. Alright guys, so that was the video. Give me some feedback, thumbs up, thumbs down, or a comment depending on what you thought about the video. If you haven't already, then please consider subscribing. That would motivate me a lot. And I'll see you in the next one.